Hey everybody, it's day 19. Can you believe it? What a marathon this has been. And again, I am really proud of you. And I know it's been a struggle for many, whether you're fasting coffee, I know it's been a real struggle. You know, I said this early on in this series that habit can be formed when you do something for 21 days and you're almost there and maybe you've begun to develop some new habits. And one of the habits that I've spoken of before and I want to speak to today is this whole idea of focusing in on our finances. And this is a real issue in the world we live in. And honestly, it's not gonna get better knowing all the things going on in the world economically. And the truth is God has a ton to say about our finances. And I wanna focus in on that today. As we pray and fast, that we focus in on the finances and the provisions that God has blessed us with. Do you realize how blessed we are? I know I am, and I wanna make sure I am a steward of what God has given me. I wanna read a scripture to you from 2 Corinthians chapter 9. And it says in verses 7 and 8, it says, "You must each decide in your heart how much to give." You have to decide this in your heart. And it's interesting that the heart is mentioned here because Jesus in the Gospels connects the heart with the treasures that we have. Think about that. Jesus connects whatever treasures, whether it's money in the bank account, whether it's material offerings that you have, whatever you might have, Jesus connects our heart to that. So whatever we have or whatever we put all our focus in on is where our heart is. And here, the writer of the Corinthians to the Corinthians says, you must decide in your heart how much to give, assuming that's what we do. We are givers. He goes on, he says, don't give reluctantly or in response to pressure. This isn't about manipulation. This is about conversation. And the scripture is real clear that God has given us, and it's up to us to decide what to give, knowing that God has given us guidelines. For God loves a person who gives cheerfully. And the original language, cheerfully, means hilariously. Like, it's not an issue. It's not my money. It's not my stuff. And God loves it when we are not so, kind of connected to materialism and money. He goes on and says in verse 8, and God will give generously, and God will generously provide all you need. Like, as you live in that space of say, it's not mine, it's yours, and you give hilariously, God will give you more than you need, and then you will always have everything that you need. And watch this, and plenty left over to share with others. Listen, God has blessed us all. And let's make today a day where we ask God in our time of prayer and fast to evaluate the finances that He's blessed us with. Are we good stewards with them? Are we hilarious givers? Maybe this is a new habit that you need to form. Because look, God is the one who's blessed us with all that we have. It's up to us to steward that and honor Him with it. So I wanna pray with you. I wanna pray that God would give you clarity on this, that He would help you. This is one of the stickiest subjects in human existence is money. Because the truth is, we think it's all ours. In the end of the day, when we have our positional correctness right, we realize that actually God provided everything that I have, and therefore it's not mine, it's His, and I'm a steward of it. So let me pray for you. Jesus, be with my friends, my family, my church community, as we wrestle with this idea of money and finances. Lord, let us realize how much that You've blessed us with, and let us hang on loosely, knowing that it's Yours, that You've given us stewardship over it. Lord, I pray that maybe there are people right now who are in time of prayer and fast, and they're wrestling with this whole idea of their finances. Lord, help them to trust You. Maybe the times are difficult financially. Maybe the times are abundant financially. God, You know, and I pray that You'd be my friends as they navigate through this. I pray in Jesus' name. Hey, thank you so much for taking the time to just hang out with me today. And I'm really proud of you. Remember this, the finish line is right ahead. There's only a couple more days left of this time of prayer and fast. I'm really proud of you. You can do it.